I've mentioned several times that causation and association are two different things. The Pearson's and Spearman's correlation is a measurement of association, and we cannot make that causal connection. And I've given you a couple of examples, but let's take a look at another example, something a little bit more obvious. Hopefully you can really catch on to the idea here. Suppose you took a bunch of elementary school kids, say grades 1 through 5 or 6, and you measured their shoe size, and then you measured their reading index. And the reading index is some type of index that measures how well they read. Well, what you expect to find, if you actually did this study, and I'm sure some government agency has done this, is a very obvious, very strong linear trend. Well, no kidding. What this is saying is kids with big feet read better. So I guess I want all my kids and grandkids and great-grandkids to have huge feet. Well, that's pretty stupid. What we're missing here is the idea of age. What we're really measuring is age. Because as kids get older, they increase in grade level and their reading ability increases. This is referred to as a confounding factor, or sometimes referred to as a lurking variable. A confounding factor or lurking variable is some variable that has a direct impact, a direct connection with what we're trying to measure, but is not controlled for. What I would expect is if we did this same thing, shoe size in reading, but we controlled for age, so maybe this is just first grade, what we're going to see is a blob. So I'm willing to bet a life supply of pizza that your size of your feet have nothing to do with how well you read. And then if we did it again for second grade, third grade, fourth grade, and individually controlling for each grade level, so we're controlling for age, we're going to see a bunch of blobs. So there is no causal factor here. We can't really say that as you increase your shoe size that your reading ability is going to go up. That's a ridiculous thing to say. Now, this is kind of a silly example, and it should be very obvious here that shoe size has nothing to do with the reading ability. But the problem is, when you're working with real data, you can't always identify confounding or lurking variables. They may be there, but you have no idea what they are. So there are a lot of data analysts, statisticians, or at least some, that feel if you can control for every possible confounding factor or lurking variable, and you still have a statistically significant trend, then you've just established a causal factor, which I tend to agree with. But the problem is, how on earth do you actually control for every possible confounding factor? You may be able to identify some and control for some, but the idea of controlling for all, I think, is easier said than done. So the emphasis here, again, is simply that association and causation are not equal to each other. They're two different things.